Hi everyone! Today we will talk about the backlog prioritization and have a look what you can do to prioritize more efficiently. Let me quickly introduce myself. I'm Niki Závadská, co-founder of jexo. In jexo we help product teams improve how they deliver work, and as you can probably guess, prioritization and planning is a big topic for us too. When we were prioritizing our backlog and work, we often bumped into these common problems. As a product manager, you are getting feedback and new ideas and feature requests from many stakeholders on a daily basis. And more than often, it happens that you can't say yes to everyone. Your stakeholders might be confused why this or that got prioritized and might have a feeling that they don't have enough influence in your prioritization process. Another problem was that when we were picking up ideas, usually the loudest person in the room took over and promoted their idea they liked most, even when it wasn't the best one, which means you might waste time and money building something which isn't just not good enough and you might miss on bigger opportunity. This is usually caused by a vague and inconsistent prioritization process. Great first step to start fixing these problems is to standardize your prioritization process. Prioritization templates allow you to create a repeatable and more transparent and less random approach to your prioritization, but also give you a great starting point for this discussion with different stakeholders. Here you can see four prioritization techniques that will allow you to calculate scores for your priorities and bring more data-driven decisions into your process. So let's have a look on them. Value versus effort model is the simplest and quickest. It's best fit for prioritizing new products or MVPs, personal to-dos or small backlogs, but also for prioritizing product feedback. Given its simplicity, you can prioritize with it literally everything. Next one is ICE, which is short for Impact, Confidence and Effort. It was initially developed for prioritizing growth experiments, but grew in popularity and is now also used for prioritizing backlog and ideas, usually when you don't have enough product usage data available. On the other hand, if you are in the position when you can actually work out usage data or other customer insights, you can use the RISE method. This method was developed by Intercom and they also use it internally. It's really simple but powerful and it helps remove bias from product backlog prioritization. Last method is called weighted shortest job first. It's usually recommended to be used by larger organizations that are using scaled agile framework. It helps with identifying and shortening long queues in projects and helps to speed up delivery process. So let's have a look on value versus effort method a bit closer. I have here example of three priorities we are going to be working on. With this method, we have two key metrics that you need to identify for each of your priorities, value and effort. When filling up value metric, ask the question, how does this contribute to your goal? In our case, we assigned medium value, which is equal to 8, to our navbar redesign, super high value to new issue detail, and high value to new onboarding checklist. You can notice that each option has its own numeric equivalent assigned. That's important as it will help us calculate the priority score and allow us to work with our priorities further. Next metric is effort. Here we will need to evaluate how difficult it is to deliver the task. Make sure that you include the effort of everyone involved in the process, from research, design, development, test, and even marketing. Sometimes we tend to underestimate how much something is going to take, especially when you only include the development effort. Some UI changes might be quick to build, but they can have a great impact on your documentation that you didn't even think of. We like to use t-shirt size estimation so people don't feel committed to the timelines. Now we are ready to calculate the final priority score. In this case, we just divide value with effort and prettify the score with just multiplying by 10. The higher the score number, the more important the priority is. You can clearly see which priorities we consider to pick up first. But just looking on the score isn't always everything. To look at your priorities from a different dimension, use priority metrics. You can build it simply by placing value metric on the x-axis and effort metric on the y-axis. Size of the bubble is the final score. Now let's see what these quadrants mean. First most important and usually most loved is quick wins quadrant. Here you will find issues that bring the biggest value and require minimal effort. If you prioritize these first, you will experience fast progress in your project. Next quadrant is the low value and high effort one. We call these priorities time sinks. If you decide to pick up and start working on priorities in this quadrant, proceed with caution. We usually keep these last or skip altogether. Other two quadrants are big projects. These tasks take long to deliver, but they also deliver high value. And fill-ins. These don't require that much effort, but value isn't impressive either. You can usually do these in between the tasks. Next prioritization framework we are going to look at is ICE. As I already mentioned, this one was created to be used for prioritizing growth experiments, but it's also good for prioritizing product backlog, especially of new products and for marketing activities. ICE is short for impact, confidence, and ease. These are also the metrics we are going to be looking at, so we can then calculate the final score. When assigning the impact metric values, ask yourself the question, how does this contribute to our goal? The goal here is anything your team or company is trying to achieve. You might be focusing on improving customer retention, increasing the brand awareness, or increasing the quality of your product. Literally anything. Assign value from 1 to 10, where 10 is the best. Next metric is confidence. Because we might be very optimistic about the impact, this metric will bring us a little bit closer to the ground. When filling this one up, ask how confident you are that this will work and deliver the impact you assigned earlier. And the last metric is ease. We already discussed this one in previous frameworks, so I won't go into too many details. Now, when we collected all needed metrics, we can calculate the final priority score. Multiply impact, confidence, and ease, and you have it. Again, the higher the score, the better. Next method we are going to look at is RISE. It's short for Reach, Impact, Confidence, and Ease. This method was developed by Intercom, and it's a great and repeatable way how to prioritize your product backlog using the usage data. You can notice that the metrics are same as from the previous ICE method, but we added Reach. This Reach metric will help you bring the actual product data and learnings into the scoring process. With each priority, find out how many customers or users does this change impact this quarter. You can think about it like this. For our navigation redesign, change will impact every user that logs into our app. If we have 2,300 users, then that's the number we are going to be using here. Next in the line is issue redesign. We can check how many users used issue detail last 3 months. And for the onboarding changes, see how many new customers you had last quarter, or if you want to be even more accurate, you can calculate how many you are expecting based on your growth rate. So it's not that hard in the end, and it really helps to make better decisions. The final RISE score is then calculated with the following formula. When you think about the differences between ICE and RISE, you can really say that ICE is better suited for new projects and MVPs in opposite to RISE, where you rely on customer usage data, which makes it more suited for already established products. The last prioritization method we are going to look at is weighted shortest job first. As the title says, this framework is focusing on identifying tasks that are most critical to be completed to reduce the queues and save time. It's usually recommended for bigger projects and organizations that use scaled agile framework. When using this framework, you are going to ask 4 key questions to fill required metrics. In the first one, you need to figure out the impact the task would have on the business. Next one will help you clarify if there is any fixed deadline or dependencies, or if we would lose the customer if we won't deliver soon. The third helps to align everyone on negative impact on the business or the goal if the task isn't going to be completed. And last question clarifies the size of the task and how fast it can be delivered. Now when we have all metrics, we can calculate the final score with following formula. This score helps understand which items to pick up first, so we reduce risk of delaying the project. It might not seem that impressive when you look on the small list like this, but imagine having backlog with hundreds of items. This might be life-changing. So these were 4 frameworks you can use to prioritize your backlog. I know it might be a bit too much to digest at first. That's why we created this freebie that helps you figure out which prioritization method is best suited for you by asking 10 simple questions. In the end, it's going to give you a link to the articles where you can find all details about selected frameworks. And as a bonus, Bot will also give you a link for an Excel worksheet that has everything ready for you to start prioritizing and use the selected method. When you are trying to introduce the prioritization methods and practices into your organization, you might find out that spreadsheets are not the best way to manage the process. People lose the link, don't look in there on a daily basis, and in a while might even get forgotten. To make prioritization process a natural part of your team's daily workflow, we created Foxly. Foxly is the backlog prioritization app that integrates with Jira, and you can access it from your project menu. It gives you an option to select from 4 predefined priority templates. You can manage and update your priorities from the interactive table, and the score will be automatically calculated for each issue. There is also an option to visualize priorities on the priority metrics, so you can easily see what is the low-hanging fruit. And if you find out that you would like to tweak the model a bit, or you want to create your own prioritization template from scratch, you can. Foxly is fully customizable. Foxly is available in the Atlassian marketplace today for Jira Cloud, so you can go and give it a try for free. Thanks for the attention, and I hope you learned something new and interesting. Just a reminder, go and try the priority bot and see what framework is the best for you and your team. Happy prioritizing!